Eric, what have we learned?
Uber lost $891 million in the second quarter of this year on $2.8 billion in revenue. So the company is back to losing money. The losses are growing sort of on one measure, while the growth of revenue is starting to slow. Year over year, you know, last quarter revenue growth was 70%, and this quarter it's down to 63%. So even as Uber's investing aggressively, it's not able to keep revenue growth quite steady.
That deceleration is probably not what Uber wants to see. And of course, Uber is privately held, but it does release some quarterly financial results to the public and to its large body of investors. My question to you, Eric, though, is that we know Dara Khosrowshahi, the CEO, is spending a lot of money into other initiatives at Uber, whether it's self-driving cars or logistics or food delivery. Are we seeing growth in those parts of the business that perhaps might be taking away from growth in the main business?
Right. Uber's, you know, not a public company. They give us the numbers that they choose to. So we don't have an exact sense of the Uber Eats business. The company has said before that it's more than 10% of bookings and growing sort of at a very rapid pace. So I think it's a reasonable inference to think that growth in Uber Eats particularly might be masking some even steeper sort of declining growth in the ride sharing business. And of course, Uber has sold off global businesses in Southeast Asia, Russia, and then China sort of a while ago now. So that also limits its growth because its global footprint is more limited. It has stakes in the companies that it's sold to, so it still has exposure to those regions, but, you know, doesn't sort of see the revenue from them.